All right, everybody, welcome to KSP Career Mode with lots and lots of mods. I don't know what episode this is. I really don't care. I now have 5 of the 12 mods updated for the 0.23 version, including MechJeb! Yay! So we'll see if it works, that little trick works that I've been using. But basically... we're going to try to go to the low solar orbit, because apparently if you get really close to the sun, you can get a different science biome than just orbiting the sun, since I already spammed the orbiting the sun biome. We're not going to use a research lab. We're just going to get our, 25% of 200 science and just do it a couple times, a couple probes. So, actually, but I am going to be sending a person. Do I want to send a person to die in the fiery pits of the sun? No, I think we're going to launch our Stay Putnik into the sun. And I don't know if we can actually make it into the sun, but we'll see. So even though we're going into the sun with a nice little pod, it is still going to be a very, very powerful rocket requirement because... let's see, we need lots of electric charge just in case, so I need, 5 of these would make, damn it, click, okay, I can't click, I wish you could just, like, drag, I mean, it doesn't, it's not important, but if you could drag and then unclick, that would be awesome. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I could use radial batteries, but what I'm doing is I'm making room. No. Yes. For my Gigantor XL solar array. Not even room for the damn thing. okay, now the ship, when it's actually in space, it can't collide with itself. So if I just, cheat here. I don't know. Hopefully those won't get ripped off by the air currents, but we'll see. don't tell the physics engine they're sideways. All right, sorry. So now we need our science equipment. There it is. So we need our utility science tab. Yes, that would make sense, would it not? So temperature, does temperature work in space? I think temperature works in space. Whoops, I don't need two. However, do not think the barometer is going to work in space. I mean, obviously. I mean, maybe it'll work the sun. I don't think there's really any atmosphere around the sun. Well, a plasma atmosphere, but obviously we don't care about plasma. Or do we? Because we can harvest it for... Well, anyway. Stick that antenna on there. Not exactly centered. I wish there was a way to center stuff like that. And then 2 goos, because we can send 2 different experiments and we'll hit our 40% science cap probably on transmission. I mean, recovery of the probe would be pretty sweet, but this one's just going to go there and hopefully die in the fiery depths of the sun. Well, why am I facing the wrong way? There we go. So let's save it. Before I save it, number 1, save. Now we need to get our MechJeb. Please, for God's sakes, let MechJeb work this time. I need it. I am crippled without it. Yes! I'm too happy about that. Oh my god, thank you. For God's sakes, thank you. Some module are disabled until you unlock the proper node and the iron... I forgot to go in and modify that so they're all unlocked right away. Because I'm a cheater. Shh, don't tell anybody. I'll have to show you guys that, actually. I'll use my screen capture software and show you guys how to modify MechJeb to work. So we're going to build the rocket. Actually, no, let's go do that right now. So we're going to save. I'm going to shut off the recorder, and then I'll come back to you once I'm done with that. All right, guys, welcome to a quick little video tutorial that's part of a bigger Kerbal video on how to modify our game. So first this. This is, I think that's awesome. I have rotating... funny desktop pictures. There's several hundred pictures that rotate on my desktop, so whenever you see my desktop, you'll see much different things every time. But anyway, so C and then x86, because Kerbal is 32-bit only, which I hope they fix soon. I mean, Space Engineers came out with a 64-bit just a few days ago, and their game's way newer than Kerbal. But anyway, so Program Files x86, then we go to Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Kerbal Space. Then we go to, maybe it's in Parts. Yes, here it is. Sorry, it was part.cfg. I'm so sorry and wasted your guys' time. It's part.cfg. Yep, here it is. Okay, so make sure Word Wrap's on so you can see everything. So basically, tech required right here, flight control. So I have flight control unlocked, so I'm just going to go to flight control, copy, and then I'm going to go down and find every single spot. I have to be very careful about this, that says tech required. You can see I'm going line by line by line. Here we go. So unlock text, flight control. So smart assistance, unlock text, flight control. Maneuver planner, advanced flight control. I don't think I have advanced flight control, and even if I did, still. So you unlock MechJeb, I want the whole thing to unlock. So node editor, advanced flight control, flight control, flight control, flight control, flight control, advanced flight control. So I'm basically unlocking MechJeb. As soon as you unlock flight control, you're unlocking MechJeb. The whole thing, which to me makes more sense. I know they're trying to make it more difficult, but I don't really give a shit because I want the game to be fun, not ridiculously challenging. I mean, I want a challenge, but not that much of a challenge. So, and then field science. So you can't even drive a rover without field science, which is a really expensive tree, especially unmanned tech. So I'm just replacing all of this. Space plane guidance, unmanned tech. That's stupid. They had computers flying planes way before they even had rockets. So anyway, you just got to change all these. Okay, so save it. My mouse is tripping out. So you save it, and then probably, I guess I should make, I probably should have made a copy of the original in case I messed something up, but I do have a copy of it back on the zip file. So I'll just do that, so nothing in the game recognizes it, but it, you know, anyway. Actually, no. Ooh, I did that wrong. Sorry. Dot mod it. That way the game can't recognize it at all. Okay, so anyway, that was it. We will now go back to the game. Alright guys, welcome back to our attempt at low solar orbit. I apologize if you have already seen that MechJeb modification video. I cut it down as much as I could to make it more streamlined, and I'm sure that you are perfectly capable of clicking past it on the YouTube slider bar. But anyway, MechJeb, obviously this is all that's available. So look, so as you can see now, there is no thing here that says you need to unlock MechJeb. So MechJeb is now fully unlocked just with the flight control science tier, which is cheating. It's blatant cheating. MechJeb is not cheating. Unlocking MechJeb early is cheating, and I don't give a fuck, and you can fucking shove it. I don't give a fuck. It's cheating, and I'm happy because I'm doing it, and I'm actually enjoying the career mode now that I have MechJeb. I am now enjoying career mode again. I was not enjoying career mode before, but I am now. So we are going to find our most efficient engine. Stupid right-click shit. 355, 400, 370, 410. Ooh. 370, 370, 390, 390, 350, 320, 100. That's a separate time. All right, here. So I think I actually just unlocked it. Okay, that's huge. This says for small aircraft. Service propulsion system for small aircraft. How much does it weigh? 2.25? I can't. The next, that's only 0.6. What the kind of bullshit is that? For small aircraft. Okay, sure, I believe you. Anyway, so we have our decoupler, and now we are going to go Oh, we need reaction wheels. Do we need them up here? Yeah, let's put some reaction wheels. Now we need to go to our tricoupler. Since I still don't have any, really big stuff. I do have a really big motor, but it's just a poodle. I guess I do have this now. What's the thrust at that? 200? The poodle, where's our poodle? Thrust is 220 with a 390. But it's 2.5, 2.25. I wonder if I could use this. This might be a very bad decision in the end, but we'll see. It's a thrust of 200. I wonder if a thrust of 200 would be enough to actually get me to space. Let's find out. Go to structural, use our adapter, go back to propulsion. Do I have a. I don't. Wait, I might not even have a large tank yet. Oh man, that might be. Oh, no, I do. Two point five. So blue is 2.5 in KW. I only have one of them. Jeez, I'm gonna need probably 405 fuel. I'm probably gonna need 0.76 thrust to weight. Huge delta V, so we could use this in space. We have 4,000 delta V in space, and then another 2,000 after that. Let's try that, and then we're going to go to our structural big coupler. And then we are going to have to go back to. This is going to be. Whoops, wrong button. I hit delete to rotate, like in Space Engineers, which is a. Blah, video series I have coming up. Just it's gonna take a while because the internet here at home in St. Louis just absolutely sucks fucking balls. Lots of balls. Chokes on them. Horrible, horrible thing to say. Okay, tricoupler. Let's use our big old bad boys here. Damn it, come on. And then we are going to go for our most powerful. Well, no, because we want that vectoring range to keep it stable. Well, I don't know if we need it, because we have MechJeb. 350, 120, 230, 215, 200, 350. Let's try 350. I mean, maybe it's just too powerful, too fast. We'll find out. Now we need aerodynamic. We're definitely going to add some stabilitator thingamajiggies. Bam. Should I add a fairing? I don't know. A lot of people are just kind of like, fairings, blah. I don't know. Let's try a fairing. Let's try it again, because before I just hated it. I have mail. So, wait, what's the difference? Now we need to mount our fairing nose cone. That is not the nose cone I'm looking for. Definitely not the nose cone I'm looking for. Can I not use the nose cone at all? What is going on? 1.25, 1.25. I'm confused. So my rocket's too tall? Is that what it's trying to tell me? I think that's what it's trying to tell me. Think you could just say that. It's like sign languaging to me. Your rocket's too tall. What's the difference between fairing cone and expanded fairing cone? Somebody's online. I don't understand. It's still not enough, man. Still not enough. Well, shit. Don't think we're gonna be able to use fairings. I thought that they had like unlimited size. I guess I was wrong. Do we get? Oh my god. No, that will not work. All right, no fairings. Sorry for wasting your time, guys. I do not need fairings if that's how they're gonna behave. Oh, I guess technically it's my fault for the way I put the solar panels on. All right, now before we put on our booster stage, we're going to start doing... I really wish those would, like, reset every time you used one. I'm sure they're working on it. You know, having certain objects have the ability to reset to your mouse, you know, or duplicate automatically would be the correct word. Or maybe maybe they have a hotkey that is, like, you know, use last part kind of hotkey. I'm not too sure about that, if we can even get... Yes. Okay, that's totally cheating, but whatever. So then we're going to do here to here. Okay. And that should be good. Well, actually, let's be safe. Oh, we need a 2. We're going to do... Whoa, that would have been bad. Totally forgot the solar panels on this side. Gonna put them down here, like this. Totally makes no sense, but we're gonna do it anyway. Okay. Yeah, that might not work. Let's go up just a bit. Just a little more, right there. Okay, they should be good there. So, yeah. Cheating, lots of cheating. 1.69, only 2000 delta V, 0.77, so we need to be in space before we get to stage 2. Or actually, yeah, that would be stage 2. Well, stage 3 once we put the solid boosters on. We also need to move this thing down to the floor. And again, I wish there was like an auto snap to floor button. It would make sense. Don't like doing this every time. Jeez, thought I rolled way more than that. Scrolled way more than that, sorry. Okay, right on the floor. Good. Wait, I can't put these on yet. Okay, structural. Let's see, do we want a large decoupler? Let's do just a... Oh, no, let's do a hydraulic detachment manifold. You know, fancy. I'm gonna get all fancy with this shit. Okay, do that. Propulsion. Solid rocket booster. Try to keep it away from the rest of the rocket. Okay. So we have those. That doesn't look... I can't tell if the thrust is going to be... It's centered. I don't know why those are curved like that. The thrust looks centered, so... Whatever. Where's our center of mass? Ah, center of mass is broken still. Fuck. Anyway. Do that. That needs to be with that. That needs to... What? No. What's wrong with you? There. That needs to be with that. That needs to be with that. And that needs to be with that. We don't need recovery parachutes, because if it blows up on the launch pad, it blows up on the launch pad. I don't really care. I don't want to waste the mass. The capacity. Whatever. Shut up. Okay. So we have only 450 meters a second delta V, but I guess that's pretty good. So then we're adding 2,000 to that, so we have... That might not be enough to get into space. Okay, well, it's version 1. We'll try it. Version 1's always blow up. Oh. No, right. No crew. Action groups. I need my science action group. So abort. And then abort will activate this panel set. This panel set. Will activate the mystery goo, and it will activate, whoops, our temperature and our barometer, even though we don't really need it or can use it. Oh, and the materials bay. So that will be our, hopefully, at least 50 science, maybe 100, depending on where we are. And then that's the end of it. Everything's done. It's permanently useless as it crashes into the sun. So save. And launch time? Yeah. Lunch time? No. Launch. Keep forgetting that I can still talk while that's loading. But anyway. Okay. I think our rocket just broke. Yeah. What the heck? Well, MechJeb's all back, so that's good. Something in the rocket broke. Broke. Disastrously, as the rocket was about to fall over, and I saved... Wait, there's no pilot. I didn't save his life, so I just wasted my time. But anyway, let's try it this way. Whoops. Maybe the rocket's too heavy. I'll add a bunch of them. Not a bunch, but I'll add enough. Okay. Then that goes back there like that. Save and launch. I'd like some lunch. It's dinner time, so lunch, dinner, linner, dunch, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, I'm a nerd. Deal with it. I have to be to play this game. Jeez. Especially with the career mode update. Man, this rocket does not look stable. All right, we are going to orbit altitude. I wonder what the altitude for breaking through free is, but we're going to prevent overheats, terminal velocity, acceleration, corrective steering, and auto stage. Since we don't have parachutes, we can leave auto stage on the whole time, which is a good thing. Auto stage helps. FAR is activated, but needs to be moved out of the way a little bit. Okay. Not too much. How far does it have to be moved? I want to move these windows around a little bit so they kind of stay out of our way. Ascent guidance, landing guidance, smart assistance. Delta V can stay right there in rendezvous. And then let's see if we have the rest. Yes, we have it all now. Yes, I am such a cheater. And I love it. Okay, sorry. Now you guys won't be able to hear me for the entire time that these engines are running. So, yeah, let's go for it. Although it looks like we're going the right direction anyway. So, is the nav fault? No, we're not. Are we? Yeah. We're going at an inclination of 0 degrees, but the nav ball says 90. What? Oh my god, I don't even know. I'm not even going to pretend to understand. Oh shit, look at this motor. Oh, it's like a thruster motor. It's not even burning because it's a space motor. Are we in space? Oh, we're still in the atmosphere. That's not good. That means we are wasting the atmospheric delta V instead of the vacuum delta V. That is not good at all. We are wasting this motor's fuel. Wow, that's kind of lame. Come on, guys. You can do better than that. Oh, I forgot to put lights on the ship so we can see it. Okay, let's open our solar panels before we run out of power. Or we can at least open two of them. I didn't touch anything. Autopilot's still running. I don't exactly know what it's doing. I think it's still trying to make it to altitude. I think maybe the panels might have had a little drag on them. We're definitely out in space now, so hopefully, yeah, we're getting much more efficient engine thrust. I always like looking at the solar panels from the other side of the sun. It's just like, da, da, da. That was totally the wrong melody, but it's just like, yeah, I'm in space, bitches. That's some sexy solar panel action. Aw, yeah. Oh, I have issues. I have lots of issues. Don't even ask. Just please don't ask. So, again, I don't even know if you guys can hear me. Can you hear me? I need to start watching my own videos. One of my friends watches all of them. So we are now coasting to the edge of the atmosphere with 4,000 delta V left. So I have mail, but I also have a feeling that we are going to at least make it to the sun's orbit, if not to the low sun orbit. Now, something that Mr. Scott Manley talked about is that if you burn in retrograde of the sun orbit, so you're on the opposite side of this. Wait, blah. I'm totally like space. Which way does this planet orbit? I think it orbits counterclockwise, right? Yeah. No. Yes. I think so. So if you are on the side of the planet with the sun, and you burn straight out this way, then you're using that fuel not only to escape Kerbin, but also to dive into the sun. So our smart assistance is off, so we're going to face our prograde, and then we're going to kind of zoom into our map here, and the ship's actually almost where it needs to be, because I'm keeping the map rotated, basically facing the sun, and I'm zooming in, and if we want our apoapsis to become going this way, then we want to thrust. Well, actually, we should probably start thrusting now, because it's a very slow thrust. It's about 1G of force. So, or maybe that's 2G, I'm not sure. 1G, half G, 15, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, it's 1G of force, so barely anything. So as you can see, our apoapsis is actually stretching out, and it's gonna be coming out and going this way to counteract the sun's force. And so we'll end up in a lower orbit, and then we can burn retrograde until we run out of fuel and hopefully fall into the sun and gather lots of science right before we get incinerated. So yes, this is actually working great. We probably started the burn a little too late, but I mean, you know, that's just how it is. So actually, it looks pretty good. It looks like hopefully we won't hit the moon or Minimus. I've done that. I wasn't paying attention, and I ended up getting into a perfect trajectory with the moon after I ran out of fuel, and so I smashed into the moon instead of making it to Minimus. I don't know if it was to Minimus or to a different planet, but I was just like, well, that sucks. Okay, miss the moon. Yeah, we're gonna miss the moon. And hopefully we'll miss Minimus, and we're actually, as soon as we break this Kerbin's grab, bam. Okay, so Now we need to time accelerate, and we need to watch out for our electric charge, because I think if we run out, we run out. Well, the solar panels, but I don't know. Anyway, I've already gathered science from all these different biomes within Kerbin's little system, or not system, within Kerbin's orbit. Would you call it a system? I don't fucking know. All right. So we are now in orbit around the sun. Now, we have already gathered and spammed science from that, but what we haven't done... 11895, 1341. What we have not done is we have not gathered near sun. I think it has to be under a million. I believe that's what Mr. Manley surmised, but I don't remember ever watching... I don't think the episode ever made it that far. All right, so we're going to retrograde. Now face our retrograde. And we are going to start burning until we are out of fuel. Well, or I should keep an eye on the periapsis. It's pretty moving pretty quickly. But I guess I could make a pass to the sun. And then if that pass isn't low enough, I could come back. I just don't want to burn up in the sun before I get my science. I don't know, I'm just going to burn till we're out of fuel. I don't care. We're going into the sun either way. It's just we'll have to be careful about how close we get and not use the super time warp if we can help it. Whether or not this is even going to get us low enough, I have no clue. So we are facing our retrograde. As you can see, there's somebody out here, I think, that needs to be rescued. Oh, he's nearby. Oh my god, look how close he is. Man, if we would have launched a manned ship with an extra capsule, we could have rescued him. No, there's three people in there. No, screw that. They're dead. They died a long time ago. I hope you guys can hear me with the motor burning in the background. So we are now at 7.5 and falling. I don't know if we're going to have enough power. Our last stage has a massive... I don't know why the thrust to weight went down. That doesn't... It was 3, wasn't it? Maybe because we're around the sun now and not Kerbin? I don't know. But it's much faster. It will burn much quicker. So yeah. I mean, we're just going for it. You know, we're going for it. We're going right in the middle, hopefully. I don't know. It's starting to look like I might not get close enough, because, I mean, you need some serious falling power to get that close. Oh, man. All right, here we go. We're about to eject stages. Let's watch that ejection. Ha. Watch that ejection. Dirty joke. And eject. Eject. That was weird. It didn't auto stage. MechJeb, come on now. So we are now burning through that fuel much quicker. 4 million. Oh man, we might not have put enough fuel on the ship to make it into low sun orbit. Because, I mean, shit. Moho. Oh, dude, what if we actually, like, go to Moho? That would be cool. 3 million. No, I don't think we did it. I don't think this is going to be considered low solar orbit. You gotta be kidding me. Oh, well, the ship is throttled up. I was like, what's going on? I think I'm gonna have to use super warp. I don't like using super warp, it's so glitchy. Oh, there he goes. Or there they go. Oh, man. Alright, we're nowhere near the sun. You gotta get way closer than that. So as soon as we hit the periapsis, I mean, we're gonna be going really fast. But we're gonna do all our science at the periapsis, and then I guess we'll just leave the probe there. Okay, stop. Okay, we are close enough. Well, let's get a little closer. Closer. Right at the periapsis would be nice. Right there. Okay, so we are now, wow, that is much brighter. Much, 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 much brighter. Turn off smartass, don't care about that no more. Well, that's not a really redneck. Abort! I can't do a temperature scan? That's bullshit. And space high over the sun. Zero science transmit, yeah. Fuck you too. Oi. Zero science transmit. Zero science transmit. That makes me mad. Can I transmit a probe report? No. So I was not close enough to the sun, so this was a complete waste of money failure. Oh well, I thought that was going to happen, so it looked like we need at least another 2,000 Delta V. How I'm going to add that with the limited parts I have no clue. I mean, I might be better off trying to go to a different planet. Ah, but rendezvous planning with MechJeb uses a lot of fuel. A lot less than what Scott Manley does, which is windows and shit. Or he finds transfer windows, but I'm not going to go through all that. So we got no science from low solar orbit 1, because it did not go to low solar orbit. So save. So we need to add more Delta V to our first stage. And how we're going to do that, I really don't. I don't know. I feel like we should use more efficient engines, but still have a really high thrust. 350 to 400, but the thrust is only 120. I need 230 with an ISP of 37. No, this is atmosphere ISP we're looking at. 325, that's not much better. 320. Just the atmosphere of 320. This one's much more efficient, but it's just not powerful enough. I think we're just going to have to add more boosters. I mean, that's really dangerous, but I don't really see a choice. I mean, I'm sure you guys probably see plenty of choices, but you know, I might not see them. So we're probably going to blow the ship into like a billion little pieces. Oops, that's not even... We only added another 400, which I guess that makes sense, but let's see. Whoops, nope, don't use those. Use these. Just kind of tack them on so they don't blow apart. Do the bottom. I gotta go above our little winglet, which seemed to help, even though I'm still a little confused by that nav ball issue. Probably can use them to stabilize this upper section too, because it was pretty freaking wobbly. I have no clue why it was so wobbly. Probably add more of these to this. Probably add them here. Try to get the wobble out of it, because that was really scary. I wish we could use a fairing. That would be neat. And I know this could probably carry... Yeah, what is wrong with me? I can add more Delta V up here. I can add substantially more Delta V up here in this little final stage. Wait, let's just see what our total Delta V was before we did that. Okay, total Delta V in vacuum is 8,423. So we are now going to delete that, add this one. It is now 8,855. Delete that. And add this one. And can I even go down low enough? And it is now 9,356. Now the only problem is this engine's not effective in the atmosphere, so we have to make sure these boosters help get us out of the atmosphere along with these powerful motors. That's too high. Man, I really want to snap the floor option, please, and thank you. Gracias. Okay. So two lower solar orbit two. We now have 9,300 Delta V. 7,500 vacuum Delta V. So if that isn't enough, then I fucking give up. So let's go for it. Oh, man. Do-do-do. Loading, loading, loading. Got a message on my phone. I'm gonna check. Let's see. Engage autopilot. Holy crap, what the f- what? Look at that. Revert to vehicle assembly. That's a problem. What happened there? Is that like that here in the assembly? Oh, they're messed up. Okay, let's try again. We'll do six of them. We'll do them. Can I go that far? Yes, I can. Okay, good. Save. Okay. So we fixed that. I'm glad I noticed that, or it probably would have crumpled in half and just got destroyed. But the question is, are these boosters going to be too powerful? You know, we have over 6,000 kilonewtons of thrust now. I mean, is that going to be too much? I think it's kilonewton. I'm not sure of the units. It's still kind of wobbly. That's really scaring me. Gauge autopilot, get those reaction wheels under control. Still increasing, and our apoapsis is so close. I should just make it 75 so it gets us into space a little more efficiently, but our apoapsis is still rising. Our time is decreasing. That's not a good sign at all. So whether or not we're going to make it to where we need to go is probably going to depend on how much fuel we waste in the upper atmosphere. We're about to leave the upper atmosphere, I believe. Where is the barometer display? In vacuum. Okay, good, good, good. So, full efficiency now. Super high efficiency on this motor. I have 5 minutes of a vacuum time that we can use, and I really wish I remembered the buttons for time warp in space, physics time warp. I guess I could look it up. No, I can't look it up. Anyway. So, MechJeb is doing a great job. We're just kind of trying to get to our... Ooh, or is it? Why is the apoapsis not going up? What's going on? Did MechJeb, like, just shit a brick or something? Oh man, this is really worrisome. I don't think I had enough. Oh, wow, how did MechJeb fuck up a gravity turn? It's increasing, but I just don't. It's we're chasing it. You see that? 26 seconds. It's increasing again. 27. Maybe it's because I hit pause. It screwed up my job. 28. 29. All right. So it's working. It's just working very slowly. Seems like a huge waste of fuel to me. Yeah, MechJeb seems to have taken control of the ship again. Does this have thrust vectoring? Maybe I gimbal, so it has thrust vectoring. I don't know if MechJeb's having trouble controlling the ship, maybe, because I put more weight on it. Maybe I need another reaction wheel. We've now gone into orbit cam. Oh, wow. That just, like, happened out of nowhere. 165. How did that happen? Oh, no, because we still have the coast to our... Oh, man, now we're going to be on the wrong side of the planet, too. Oh, I need to open the solar panels before we run out of fuel. Oh, shit, look what it just did. Wait, did I do that? Oh, no, MechJeb's piloting. I was going to say, whoa, that would be kind of weird for solar panels to do that in the middle of space. It's ion wind. Space is killer. I don't know. Don't ask. Oh shit, they went into time warp. Do-do-do-do-do. Non-physics time warp disables the control of objects. I know that, I've known that. Ooh, the solar panels are like semi-see-through, that's kind of cool. Unless that's some kind of reflection of the moon, that would be really neat. I think that's a moon reflection. No, it was a sun see-through, it was... Time warp, 1x. Extend those panels, please. All right, now we only have to go 28.7, so we did a very low gravity turn. I have a feeling that MechJeb didn't really want to do it that way, and we just kind of got, you know, yeah. So, we are going to do that. Okay, so now we want to face our prograde, and we want to face the sun. For this, so our probe needs to come around the planet a little more. Need to come around to about there. We'll just do that for now, because I want it to... Okay, about there. Start thrusting. Now I know there's a physics warp, I just don't know what it is. Was it shift? Cannot warp faster, so it's not shift. What was the physics warp in space? Ah! Angry! Yeah, I know, thank you! Ugh. I don't like wasting your guys' time. Man, what was it? I know it was... Okay, I'll look it up while this is doing this. So, my trusty cell phone, the Googles. Let's see, Kerbal Space Physics Warp. Physics warp, is that what it's called? I don't know. We'll see. Google will tell me the correct name. Time warp. Oh, wait. Physics warp in space. There it is. No, go back. Shit. It was right there. It was on the Kerbal Space Program forum. Ooh, looks like we're about to eject into the sun. Yep, we almost hit in the orbit with the moon. That would have been bad. And we're in the sun. Okay, so now we can time warp our way out there. Look at that craft, like, spinning around. Come on, you stupid phone. Don't tell me the Wi-Fi internet just went out again. Oh, I'm not even on Wi-Fi. What the hell? Come on, load the thread. Alt. It's alt. Alternate. I feel so smart. It's the one thing I didn't try. All right, so we are now going to hit our retrograde, and we are going to zoom out, and we are going to find our, let's see, 13, 12. So it's not much of a difference, but I don't want to waste any fuel. So we're going to, I don't want to waste fuel this time. So we are going to take a nice long trip around the sun. Probably shouldn't have done that. Probably should have just started thrusting, but whatever. Everybody loves to thrust. Nice long trip around the sun. Man, no yawning. No, I had plenty of sleep last night for once in like a week. So, the night before last, we played PlayStation Move bocce ball and disc golf. All night. We got drunk. Because if you got under par, over par, disc golf, you had to take a drink. And we all got over par. Many times. Oh crap, don't collide with that. Oh man, that would be hilarious if it collided. And all those millions of miles of space, the probes collide. It sounds like a porn movie name. The probes collide. Triple X edition. All right. And whoa, we just sped up a lot. Duh, stop. Okay, we're facing our, we're about to face our retrograde. So now we can, okay, throttle up. We're gonna burn all our fuel, no matter what. So we can now kind of watch and maintain. So alt. There we go, physics warp in space. And you're supposed to keep an eye on this and make sure your ship doesn't shake apart or anything, but it seems to be working. Because otherwise this would have been a very long video. It's already a long video. This is gonna be the last part of the video. So yeah. Oh sweet, my friend just confirmed that we're going on vacation this weekend. Hey Dad! Evan just confirmed. We're going. So, we are now on our last super efficient stage, and we are time warped, and we are burning through the fuel. Now the ship's a little spinny. We are 4 million, 3 million. Let's kind of zoom around here. Got to be below a million. 2.5. Oh no, please don't tell me I still don't have enough fuel. I'm gonna be so pissed. 1.7. 1.5. No! 1.4. Oh god, please don't tell me I just wasted all that time. Oh, gotta unthrottle. I'm gonna be so mad. You've gotta be shitting me. Fuck, we're just gonna have to go to Eve. Or Duna. Duna's pretty close. We can go to Duna, I guess. That was more than enough fuel to get to Duna. Probably to any of these planets. I mean, look how close we are to Moho. So, I guess we'll just start going to planets then and just gathering orbiting data or past solar pass-by data from those planets. Because I need the science. I want to unlock the big, fat rocketry objects, and I can't do that without science. I'm enjoying science career mode again. I still don't like the 40% transmit limit. I don't like that at all. I think that's stupid. No matter how many times you go to the same spot, you can always learn something new unless you're a shit scientist, which apparently these little green guys are shit scientists. So please be in low solar orbit. For God's sakes, don't do this to me. High over the sun. Oh. Literally, just fuck. Fuck. I'm just gonna leave it spinning. Fuck it. Okay. Alright, that is the end of this episode. On the next episode, we will attempt to put a fairing on this. Well, I guess we can't put fairings on, can we? So, I don't know. We'll figure it out. We'll, what was I saying? Right. Next time we're going to be going to at least two different planets in the video, unless there's some spectacular crash. So thanks for watching. Thanks for sticking in through the whole thing. Please subscribe. It really means a lot to me. You know, one click for you is a bunch of help for me, and I would really appreciate it. So thanks very much, guys. I will see you next time.